Good morning. In case anyone was wondering, no, I didn't finish. It's been a long couple of days. What, buddy? Come here. What's up? I'll make lunch when I'm done with my class. Okay. We have a hungry boy today. Okay, so we are going to do our snowman today. Let me get him where I want him and then I will move. Whoa! There. So we're gonna do our snowman today. I'm going to start with his hat and then, no, I'm going to do his head first and then the hat. Okay. So I want the snow to be kind of sparkly. So I'm going to use, the Blanc thread and Etole. So I'm just going to use one strand of this because it's a little bit gray. But mixed with the white thread, it should be good. So I'm going to use all six, and then I'm just going to add maybe two strands of that. And we'll see how that looks. All right. So I'm just going to cut them the same length. Kind of quiet today with just a couple of us. Okay, so there's my six, and there's two. What, buddy? Yeah, you can lay down. Go ahead. Go get a blanket from Roman's room. You can get a pillow if you want. Okay, you just get what you want from Roman's room. Okay. Okay, so I've got both of these in my needle. And then I'm just gonna tie them together at the end, make a little knot, and we will get started. How loud is Finding Nemo? Can you hear that? I think I might need to turn down the movie that they're watching. Hold on. I'm gonna go turn down the volume on the kids' TV. All right, so we are just gonna cover up all of this. So kind of just remember approximately where everything is. So I feel like snowmen have a little texture, so I don't want to do satin stitch. We're gonna do a stem stitch. So we're gonna do the outside edge first. So stem stitch, we make a little stitch, keep the loop, and then come up in the middle of the loop and pull that snug. And then we're going to make another stitch that's this same length from here to here, except it's going to go from here to here. Okay, we're going to keep that loop and come back up in the middle. There we go. So we're gonna do that all the way around. So keep your loop on the outside. You don't want to change directions or else it's gonna, whoops, what am I doing here? Hold on. I don't know what was going through my head just now. But you want your loop to stay on the outside of your curve. But I have found that since we're going this way with our thread, when you pull it snug, pull it that way, and it will help keep your threads a little bit smoother. So if you don't love the way this looks, you can always satin stitch this, which is what we're gonna do with the hat. So if you don't love how this turns out, feel free to do something different. You could also, depending on what color your fabric is, like mine's white, so I could just outline this and call it a day. I'm gonna fill it in just because I want that texture. Plus I'm filling in the hat, so. And then we're just gonna do the other stitches just right over the top of it. Hey, you guys, leave the window alone, please. Okay, so we're gonna end there. So if you want to outline and be done, that's fine. I'm gonna go back. So I ended my needle here. So I'm gonna come up right here and just do a small stitch this way. And then keeping the loop on the outside, I'm just gonna do another row of these. No, you can do it, buddy. And then, so we're just gonna go back this other way. And fill that in. And I'm just keeping my loop still on the outside because that's the way I'm curving. Oop. Now these don't have to be like super duper close to each other because they're kind of like we used a lot of thread. but they need to be semi-close together to fill that space. Especially if you're using a colored fabric, you're going to want to make sure you maybe keep these a little bit closer together. If you're using a white, you might not need to get them quite as close. My stitches are getting bigger. I sometimes forget to keep them even. Okay. Going back the other way again. This one takes a little bit longer than it would like if we sat and stitched it, but I don't know, I think it's still fun. Probably gonna need more thread though. What, honey?
I have balloon.
You have your balloon?
Yeah, I need.
My little kiddos are extra loud today.
Mommy, I have a popsicle.
We're not gonna have any popsicles right now. Your popsicle yesterday.
No, I want another one.
Hey, Roman. I'm doing my class right now, and when I'm done, we can talk about it. Thank you. Four-year-olds are really fun. These inside circles just will start to get a little bit smaller, so they'll go a little bit faster. I have a 3-year-old and 5-year-old. I get it. Oh man, just these loud children. I have my 4-year-old, and then I watch a friend's little boy on Wednesdays, and he is 3. And some days they get along so well, and other days I'm like, oh my goodness. Today they're doing pretty well, but Roman seems... Hey, stop, please.
No, I want popsicles.
I'm not doing popsicles right now.
No, I want.
I was not expecting the scream.
No, I want.
Sometimes we get the scream and sometimes we don't.
Mommy.
Roman? I'm not doing popsicles right now. He always wants treats in the morning. I think, was it last week? He was asking for ice cream and it was like 10 a.m. Who was here for that? That one was too long. Do you see how long this is right here? And so it's like, if I pull this, I need to make this a little bit shorter. So instead of going like up here, I'm just gonna go right here so I can get this one tacked down a little bit better. That was a little longer than I meant for it to be. 3-year-old and 5-year-old here too. We're all watching with my 5-year-old homesick. They identified with the scream. My daughter asked for slushies. Yes, we love slushies as well. We do those a lot. We're working on potty training still. He has been my hardest to potty train. And we've been doing rewards. And he usually wants to go to 7-Eleven and get a Slurpee. See, this stitch is a little more time consuming, but I think it will be worth it. You're hungry today, huh, buddy? Mm-hmm. He's picking at his leftover breakfast. My daughter is 7. 7 is a good age. My daughter is also 7. Thank goodness they're at school though. I tried to make sure that this stitch along would be while we mostly had school. We're done on the 17th for Christmas. Okay, I'm gonna tie this off and get another piece. What do we think? Are we liking that texture? I think it's kind of fun. Look at the back. Cute, it's a little rainbowy. Okay. Oh my gosh, I find the attitude can be a bit much at times. She's like a mini teenager already. I don't struggle as much with that as I do with like the constant asking the same question. What, honey?
I don't want popsicle.
You want a popsicle?
Yeah.
Okay. Listen, I'm not going to do it right now while I'm doing my class, but when I'm done, we can have lunch and then we can have a popsicle.
My chair.
Okay, you sit in that chair. What?
How would you get it down?
No, you're not going to get it down. I will get it down after lunch.
No. Mom, I'm way strong. I'm strong.
I know you're strong, sweetie.
I want to be strong. Wait, Mom.
You want to be strong?
Yeah.
Okay, be strong and wait for me. Roman is usually not so chatty. Oh, he's just gonna go ahead and grab his own. Hey! I wish you'd get down from there.
No.
Oh my goodness. Independent child is going to get his own. Okay, so here's, like, if I ever have this happen, like I just have one thread that didn't make it in. So I'm just gonna pull these down here so they're out of the way. And just get this one at the top. And then I'll pull that through. Then I don't have to like redo the entire bunch.
Help!
Help! I will help you when I'm done. Get down. He must really want it. Yes. Yes, he does. He's got the freezer open with a stool next to it, trying to reach the top. Now he's trying to get our little friend to help him. we'll see what happens if they can really reach them or not. I don't think they can. We have like a side by side and they're at the top. Oh! Roman, huh? Go put that back.
No.
Yes.
Come on, touch it out.
Okay, go close the freezer.
Me, I want one.
Well, if Roman can reach one, I guess we're having... I guess we're going to have to deal with that later. Oops, sorry.
I want one.
Roman, is there another one?
Yeah.
Okay, go get it for Stetson then.
You're so high.
Oh my goodness. I'm losing all control over here, people. The children have taken over. He's not going to put it back. No, he's not. Oh, I have lost control of the children.
Mama.
What, honey?
I don't know how to open it.
You don't know how to open it?
You do it.
No.
Why?
You got it out. You do it.
Well, how do we do?
You have to open it.
I don't know how to open it.
You guys. If I wasn't live, things would be going differently over here. Let me see it. Hold on. I gotta get a popsicle for the other kid. Just a minute. Get out of here, you weirdo. All right. Oh, goodness sake. All right. Well, there's your entertainment for the day. Keep life interesting. Getting there, we're getting there. I'm sorry. At least I entertained you while we do this over and over and over. Right? That's what I'm here for, the child entertainment. And I have a knot. So close. It's looking cute. I like how padded it is. Yeah, I like it too. I feel like it's some good, I love embroidery with good texture. So like, as much as I love satin stitch, it's nice to mix it up and like add some texture. And yeah, with this many threads, it will for sure give it kind of a padded, full look. But I understand that is not everyone's style, so feel free to do what makes you happy. And I also know that this is a little time consuming. So I get if you don't have time to do this whole thing, because we still have the hat and the face, which actually I'm going to leave the eyes and the mouth until next week when we do French knots. I only like to teach French knots once. So if you already know how to do French knots, that's what I'm planning on doing for his face, for his eyes and mouth. I'm not gonna do it today because we'll just do all the French knots all at once. And I'm not doing that until next week. I keep getting knots. It's a lot of thread. Have this one loose little thread here, so I gotta figure out which one it is. Pull it snug. Come on now. That will bug me. Ugh. Okay, I'll have to fix it when I go back around. Look how close, we're almost done. Okay, so when I go back around, I'm just gonna pull that in and put it under. That was a little stitch, what was I doing here? So I'm just gonna put my needle, so it's a loop right here. So I'm just gonna put my needle through that loop so I can tack it down. So it's not sticking up like that. Gets a little tricky here at the end. You kind of lose the shape a little bit of that arc. So just start filling it in. They both taste the same. You don't need to taste each other's. Now they're sharing popsicles. Okay, so I think right here, I'm just gonna do just some straight stitches and just fill this in a little. I think it'll take just two or three little stitches to just fill it in. Okay, and then I like to just look and see if there's any spots that look a little funny. Like right here looks a little funny. So I'm just gonna go in and just kind of fill it in a little. And especially if you're using a darker fabric, if you can see spots that are just bugging you. Before we put this thread color away, I'm just gonna fill in a couple spots that aren't quite looking like I want them to. There. I think that's better. One more right here. There. I think we're good. Okay. There's our snowman head.
Mom!
What?
I ate my mouth cold.
Your mouth is cold?
Yeah.
You ate that popsicle very fast. Oops. other way. Okay, so let's do his nose real fast, and then we will move on to the hat. So if you have a scrap of orange, if you didn't, I'm sorry that you had to buy for this little teeny tiny nose. So I'm using DMC 900, but you can use any orange that you have. Whatever orange, if you have a scrap, or if you have something you bought for another project, or whatever. I'm just gonna do a triangle. I don't really want to do too much over these stitches. So I'm just going to do one more stitch just down the middle.
Yeah.
And call that his nose. Okay, and then we'll go back in and do the mouth and eyes when we do French knots day. Moving on, we're gonna use black, which is DMC 310. Depending on how puffy you want this hat, you could use anywhere from 4 to 6 strands. I'm gonna use 6 just because why not? So I'm going to do the hat and in vertical satin stitch, and then I'm going to do this ribbon red in a horizontal satin stitch. So I'm going to just, I don't like starting in the corner because I don't like having a knot right there on the end. So I'm just going to start over here and then I will go back to the corner. So I want to keep these nice and smooth. Hold on, this isn't quite tight. Satin stitch is really hard if your fabric is not tight. So do what you can to get that snug. So we're just going to go, I always like going top to bottom. I know some people don't care what way they go. But we're just gonna lay these right next to each other. No. And fill this space up. Now, if your stitches are not perfect, I mean, if you can keep your line on top nice and straight, that's great. If you can't, don't worry too much. We can outline it. Okay, go put it in the garbage, buddy.
No! Oh, yeah, Mom.
Yeah, he's done, honey. He doesn't have to eat the whole thing if he doesn't want it. Okay. Okay, I need you to go use the stool in the bathroom and wash your hands. Sticky hands. Anyways, if you're not loving like the top, if it gets a little jagged, we can outline it. So don't stress about it if it's not looking quite how you want it to. Oops, that was not close enough. I'm gonna put another one in between them. Your house sounds like my house. You missed the popsicle situation that we just had. It's 10:30 here and my 4-year-old just used a stool to climb up and get some popsicles out of the freezer. So, you know, we're winning over here. I'm sure he feels like he's winning. We're getting the Legos out. How resourceful of him. Yes, he is very resourceful. All right, if you want to get dressed, you can, but I cannot help you right now, so you'll have to do it by yourself. Or you can wait until I'm done. Okay. He was definitely winning until he couldn't then open it. But then I opened it for him. So I'm sure he could have figured it out. It's been an entertaining day with the children. I'm sorry, today is a lot of work. And I got offline up here, but I wanted to keep this straight, so just is what it is.
Hey, Wolfman.
No, no tents right now. No.
Whoa!
They fight over tents. You guys don't want to hear that? All right. There we go. Cute little top hat. Okay, so hey, Roman, stop, please. He's stepping on his Legos on purpose so that he can say, ow, 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 ow. I'm going to do a horizontal satin stitch on this because I don't want to do teeny tiny ones on these edges. So I'm going to come and do the middle first. You can still do vertical if you want, but this video is getting long and vertical will take a long time. And then to save a little thread, I'm gonna go back this way. And then I can fill it in a little bit later. So we're gonna kind of do like we did with our leaves. So we want this rounded. So if you do two or three stitches right next to each other and then start moving down the sides, it'll give it a more rounded look rather than like a pointed look. So I'm gonna come down here. Roman. What? Well, stop stepping on them, honey.
Oh, goodness.
You like stepping on them? Kids are so weird. Okay, so I'm going to do one more right next to that one. And then I think I just need two more stitches. I'm gonna do one more. Roman? Roman? Oh my gosh. One more there, and then one more down the center. Okay. LOL, why is that fun? I have no idea. Kids are crazy. So this is like a traditional satin stitch. It'll cover up the back as well. I was trying to save thread and I did it this way on the back this time. Because I didn't want to get out a new piece of thread. Okay, so we just have the ribbon left. Sounds like he's having a lot of fun. They are having fun. But I didn't let them watch shows until I was starting this, hoping that they would sit quietly, but I like to not do that. Okay, so we're gonna go and fill in the red. I'm gonna use both of these. So 3777 and C321, because I want this sparkle. And I'm liking the sparkle ratio on the snowman. So this was 6 of the white and then 2 of the sparkle. So I'm gonna do that again.
Mommy.
What, honey?
He will win a day. Whoa.
What is that?
A howler.
Oh, okay. Can I have it?
No, he has win a day.
I'll put it in the game. Give it to me.
No, come on.
Okay. He found a Monopoly piece.
Monopoly day.
We can play a game when I'm done, honey. Okay. Just grab 2 strands of this red. Mine woke up smelling like chocolate. She ate her advent calendar all by herself. Oh my gosh. Kids, they are maniacs. We didn't do chocolate advent calendars this year. We're doing 25 days of Christmas. And so they've been getting like a small gift every day. And so it's been fun. No, I'm not going to come on right now.
What the hell would we do?
I told you I would do the game after I'm done.
How is that? How is that?
Okay. So I'm thinking on next week about adding like a little holly leaf on this as well, which I think could be so fun, but I'm going to save that for French knots because that's what I want to do is like little French knot berries. Okay. Woo! We made it. We survived. Okay, so. Okay, that's okay if you got a game out, sweetie. So if your top is not feeling very straight or if you're just not liking it, you can go and backstitch it. Or just do one straight stitch from here to here. Whatever you want to do with that. So backstitching we've done. Oh, we did it yesterday. So if you weren't watching yesterday. So you would do a stitch like from here to here. And then here to here. And here to here. Here to here. Since it's black, you won't be able to see the... you won't be able to see the breaks as much. But you can also just leave it if you want. I'm just throwing it out there. So anyways, we will add... a little holly to his hat and eyes next week. I'll say it again. If you know how to do French knots, that's what I'm planning for the mouth and eyes. I'm just not teaching him today. So anyways, there's our snowman. He's so cute. I like him a lot. So I hope you enjoyed today. So tomorrow and Friday, we're going to do Santa Claus. We're going to do some turkey work. And yeah, it's going to be fun. So see you then if you're doing the Christmas one or if you just want to come hang out with me because we might have crazy four-year-olds. Let's see. We also have her mini book advent, but that's for bedtime. Four-year-olds are so fun. Oh, yeah. I saw somebody else had one of those, like a little book you read every day. I think my friend has one. All right. Enjoy your Wednesday. And I am going to sit here and try to finish stitching because I've got this and this and over here a little bit more. So anyways, I'm going to try and get this done. Let's see if I can put off lunchtime for these two boys. All right. Have a good day. Thanks for hanging with me and listening to our crazy antics. See you tomorrow. Bye.